In this video and subsequent videos, we're going to be talking about the protocols used in IPv6. Now, if you haven't already, I'd invite you to actually watch this video where I explain IPv6, how the IP addresses are set up, and how to understand them and how to abbreviate them. So we go into that all in this video, so I invite you to check that out. But in this short video, we're going to be talking about the major protocol, one of the major protocols used in IP. It's also used in IPv4, but we're going to talk about the difference in this IPv6 protocol, ICMP. Why we need it, how it's used, and how it differs in IPv6 versus how it used to be used in IPv4, or how it's still used in the old IPv4 system. So stay tuned. In this short video, I'm going to show you one of the most widely used protocols, ICMP, and how it differs with IPv6 from the way it's used with IPv4. First, when we're talking about ICMP for IPv6, we just call it ICMP v6. So when you see ICMP v6, just know from now on that it's talking about ICMP when it's used with IPv6. So now that we got all those acronyms out of the way, when used with IPv6, ICMP is still used for error and status information, but there have been some modifications to it. ICMP v6 still uses types and codes just like ICMP v4. So let's take a quick look at those. For ICMP v6, when you use types from 0 to 127, these are used for error messages, and 128 to 255 type numbers are used for informational purposes. Then you have the codes that go along with the types. So codes give us more detailed information for either the error or the information type. For example, for the returned error type 1, destination unreachable, there are 8 different codes from 0 through 7 that can be used along with that type. So each one represents a different reason for why the destination was unreachable. And a few of those you might see would be no route to destination, communication with destination administratively prohibited, and port unreachable. Now there are also some additional features in ICMP v6 when compared to ICMP v4. Multicast listener discovery, or MLD, this kind of replaces the multicast protocol used in IPv4 that was known as IGMP, and that stood for Internet Group Management Protocol. So MLD, multicast listener discovery, is used for multicast communication in ICMP v6. The other feature that you might want to be aware of in ICMP v6 is neighboring discovery, or ND. This essentially replaces the ARP that was used in IPv4, and it does the same function, essentially. However, ND is also responsible for automatic address alignment, neighboring router discovery, and duplicate address correction. So when it comes to the ICMP protocol used in IPv6, again, better known as ICMP v6, know the basics. There are types and codes. Types 0 through 127 are for error messages. Types 128 through 255 are for information. And then you have codes that go along with those types. Codes break down different reasons for each type that is returned in the information. And two of the additional features of ICMP v6 that you need to know about, not in ICMP v4, are multicast listener discovery, or MLD, and neighboring discovery, ND.